Though we often hear how we should stop worrying about if people like us or not, it is always a good idea to put your best foot forward when meeting someone new.
So former Marine and author Eric Rittmeyer is an expert in emotional intelligence and what he calls mental toughness. He joins us with his secrets to get anyone to like you, and it could all start with a smile. And you've got a wonderful smile, so I'm already liking you.
I owe you for that. You say you got change for 50?
No.
That was very nice. Thank you. It does all start with a smile. It does all start with a smile, which is how I came up with that little silly acronym, Smile Factor.
Yeah.
Because it does start with a smile, because you have a very short period of time to make a first impression.
Yeah.
And our society, just we're more about our cell phones than we are about personal communication.
But what if somebody doesn't smile? I've encountered this where I smile at somebody, and like I get this whole like, why are you looking at me kind of like response, and I'm like, oh no, do they not like me?
Yeah, you have to get over the approval addiction. You're right. Some people do that, and you can't always get through, but I will tell you, 99% of the time, people are going to reciprocate however you approach them. So when somebody initially doesn't come across as being smiley or happy, they're really because they've probably been around other people who aren't smiling and happy. Mm. When you come at them, which I do, I'll get in your face. If you're not smiling, I'm coming at you. I'm going to be up in your grill. Right? You're going to smile at me. I'm not going to pay for my coffee. But it's just one of those things. Some people you can't break, but the majority of people, they just want somebody to be nice to them, and they'll be nice back normally.
All right. So let's go through the smile acronym that you have so that you can teach us and our viewers at home how we can get people to like us.
Yeah, it starts off with the S, which is just show me respect.
Okay.
And I'm talking about more than please and thank you. That's a given. We do the please and thank yous. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about just giving somebody undivided attention when you meet them initially. Mm-hmm. Like, you want to make that person feel like your world revolves around them. It's letting them complete their sentences. Don't cut them off. Don't, you know, look around, be on your cell phone. It's giving them undivided attention.
And that's exactly what you're doing to me right now.
I am, because you're giving it back.
Okay.
You're giving it back.
Great. All right. Check.
So the M.
The M. Make it all about me. So this is something where just when you're with that person, when you're talking with that person, you just want to make them feel like whatever they're saying, whatever they're feeling, whatever's important, it's just you're all into them. You're all about that person. Nothing else matters at that point. Mm-hmm. So I use what's called a FROM. It's the FROM acronym. It's family, recreation, occupation, motivation.
Wow.
So you're trying to find something that you can find common ground on amongst one of those things. Once you do find common ground with somebody, normally that's almost an instant connection.
This is an acronym within an acronym.
It is. I was in the Marine Corps, so we're all about our acronyms, okay?
Okay.
The eye, right?
How long were you in the Marine Corps?
Just 4 years. I can work wonders with spoons.
See, that was me trying to engage you right there, asking about you, right?
That was a good one. I didn't even know you were doing that.
I'm picking her. She's laying down.
Look
I'm with
at that.
Her.
Okay. All right.
The eye.
The eye.
Make me feel important. Okay. So this is, I have two teenage daughters. It's one of these things where people, again, you just want to make them feel like everything's about them, and we just don't, you know, you hear these old phrases about people forget about what they say, people forget about what they do, but they'll never forget about how you made them feel.
Yeah, right.
And that goes a long, long way. If you can take that time to make them feel like they're important, they're going to really come back at you and be like, well, I really like, what is it I like about that person? It's called effective presence. So effective presence is when I can enter a room and make everybody around me feel good, even if I don't feel good internally. It's called effective presence.
So okay. I like that. So the L.
The L.
It's not for Lindsay, although that helps.
I could improvise. I can change that. Make me laugh.
Okay.
Oh,
that's a good one. See, I made you laugh.
You
Look
did.
At that.
You
I did
are
it.
A comedian. I love that. It's make me laugh. It's really the easiest of all of them, but people have a hard time doing it. Like, just be silly. Everybody's so crazy, like regimented, like, oh, but here's your change, sir. It's like, just be silly, be goofy. Everybody wants to be goofy. Nobody doesn't want to, everybody wants to laugh.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of approaching that person. Sometimes you might feel a little bit crazy about it, but I do it all the time. Just people want to laugh. Make them laugh. It's the easiest thing to do.
And it really, it cuts down on like just some of that tension. And I think then you make them laugh and then they're smiling. And then I feel like everything else just kind of naturally sometimes
I tried
happens.
That in my drive down from Baltimore. I was talking to Jess. So people in D.C. are crazy drivers. I'm trying to make them laugh. Driving down the road, they're saying not nice things to me. I'm like, just laugh. Come on, kuna matata.
Just exactly.
Yeah.
That's sometimes the best. I know this is probably not
song.
The worst thing. It's the best. Hakuna matata. But you know, you just smile and wave.
It means no
you
worries.
Know. Exactly.
The last one's
the
E.
Rest of a day.
Exactly. Don't make me sing. I'm not going to. I'm not
okay.
doing it.
I'll do it for you.
The E is earn my trust. Now, this one's a little more difficult because you can't just instantaneously earn someone's trust, but you can start on day one. And the great thing about trust is if I show you I trust you, so if I maybe tell you something that's private or personal, you almost kind of feel like you want to tell me something back because I've trusted you.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a little tricky, but it's one of those things where if you make that person feel like they're trusted, they're going to want to give it back to you. But it is a little more difficult to do.
Awesome. Wonderful.
And there's more that we can learn. You have a book out, right?
I do have a book. I know I'm a Marine. I can't read. I can't write. I did write a book. It's in crayon. Do you guys write? It's in crayon, for real.
He's funny.
The Emotional Marine. I wrote it. It's about how to get people to like you instantly. It's on my website, mentaltoughnessspeaker.com.
Nice.
Well, wonderful. Nice. Eric, thank you awesome. So much
thank
for
you for
coming
having
in.
Thank it was you. Wonderful. It was
appreciate
a pleasure.
Appreciate it. Very much. Thank you. I appreciate your time.
Thank you.
All right. Nice.